assistant professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today, in system of linear equations and matrices, I will teach you new topic, that is solution of homogeneous system of linear equations using Gauss-Jordan method. So let's start. So first of all, we will see actually what is a system of homogeneous linear equations. A system of m homogeneous linear equations in n variables, x1, x2, xn, or simply a linear system, is a set of m linear equations, each in n variable. A linear system is represented by a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus dash 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 a1n xn equals to 0. Then after second equation, a21 x1 plus a22 x2 plus dash 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 a2n xn, that is equals to 0, and so on. am1 x1 plus am2 x2 plus dash 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 amn xn, that is equals to 0. Now here you can find 0 everywhere in the right hand side of the given system of equations. So this type of system of equation is called homogeneous system of linear equations. Now writing these equations in matrix form, Ax equals to 0, where capital A equals to A11, A12, up to A1n in first row, A21, A22, up to A2n in second row, and so on. And in nth row, we have am1, am2, up to amn. This is called coefficient matrix of order m by n, where x equals to x1, x2, up to xn. This is any vector of order n by 1, and 0 equals to 0, 0, up to 0. This is a null vector of order n by 1. Now we will see how to find out the solution of homogeneous system of linear equations. So solution of homogeneous system of linear equations using Gauss-Jordan method. For a system of m linear equations in n variables, there are two possibilities of the solution to the system. Possibility number one, the system has exactly one solution, that is x1 equals to 0, x2 equals to 0, and up to xn equals to 0. And this solution is called the trivial solution. The system has infinite solution. The homogeneous system of linear equation is always consistent. It means it has at least one solution. And if it has unique solution, then it will be 0, 0, 0 solution, which is called trivial solution. And it may have an infinite solution. When the system of linear equations has one or more solution, then the system is said to be consistent. The matrix A colon B, that is equals to A11, A12 up to A1n, and along with this we have 0. This is in first row. Now A21, A22 up to A2n, and along with this we have 0. And up to in nth row we have AM1, AM2 up to AMn, and along with this we have 0. This matrix A colon B is called the augmented matrix of the given system of linear equations. To solve a system of linear equations, elementary row transformations are used to reduce the augmented matrix to either row echelon form or reduce row echelon form. Reducing the augmented matrix to reduce row echelon form is called Gauss-Jordan method. Now we will see how to apply the Gauss-Jordan method. The Gauss-Jordan method for solving the linear system is as follows. Step number one, write the augmented matrix. Step number two, obtain the reduced row echelon form of the augmented matrix by using elementary row operations. Step number three, write the corresponding linear system of equations from reduced row echelon form. Step number four, solve the corresponding linear system of equations by back substitution. So these are four steps. With the help of these steps, we can find out the solution of given system of homogeneous linear equations using Gauss-Jordan method. Now we will see examples related to this topic. Example number one, solve the following homogeneous system of linear equations by Gauss-Jordan method. And equation number one is -2x1 plus x2 minus x3 equals to 0. Equation number 2 is x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3 equals to 0. And equation number 3 is 3x1 plus x3 equals to 0. Now first of all, we will write down the matrix form of the system, and that is, in the first row we have minus 2, 1, minus 1. In the second row, 1, 2, 3. In the third row, 3, 0, 1. This is matrix A, and along with this we have a column matrix, which is a matrix of given variables, that is x1, x2, x3, and that is equals to a 0 matrix, 0, 0, 0. Now we will write down the augmented matrix of the system, and that is minus 2, 1, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 3, 0, 1, 0. Now reducing the augmented matrix to row echelon form. So first of all, we will apply the operation R12. It means we will interchange the row number 1 and row number 2. So after applying this operation, we have this resultant matrix, that is 1, 2, 3, 0 in the first row, minus 2, 1, minus 1, 0 in the second row, 3, 0, 1, 0 in the third row. Now we will make the elements minus 2 and 3, which are below the leading one, which is present at position 1, 1 to 0. So for that purpose we will apply these operation, that is R2 plus 2R1 and R3 minus 3R1. So by applying these two operations, row number 2 and row number 3 will be modified and row number 1 will be as it is. So we have this resultant matrix, 1, 2, 3, 0 in the first row, 0, 5, 5, 0 in the second row, 0, minus 6, minus 8, 0 in the third row. Now you can see first non-zero element, which is 5 in the second row from the left hand side. Now we have to make this 5 to 1. So for this purpose we will multiply row number 2 by 1 by 5. So row number 2 will be modified and row number 1 and row number 3 will be as it is. So this is the resultant matrix, that is 1, 2, 3, 0 in the first row, 0, 1, 1, 0 in the second row, 0, minus 6, minus 8, 0 in the third row. Now we will make minus 6 to 0, which is below leading one present in row number 2. So for that purpose we will apply this operation, that is R3 plus 6 R2. So by applying this operation, row number 3 will be modified and row number 1 and 2 will be as it is. So this is the resultant matrix, 1, 2, 3, 0 in row number 1, 0, 1, 1, 0 in row number 2, 0, 0, minus 2, 0 in row number 3. Now we will make minus 2 to 1, which is present in row number 3, the first non-zero element from the left hand side. So for this purpose, we will multiply row number 3 by minus 1 by 2. So row number 3 will be modified and row number 1 and 2 will be as it is. So this is the resultant matrix 1, 2, 3, 0 in the first row, 0, 1, 1, 0 in the second row, 0, 0, 1, 0 in the third row. This is a row echelon form because as you can see, we have leading one in row number 1, leading one in row number 2 and leading one in row number 3. Now we will find out its reduced row echelon form, and first we will make 3 and 1 to 0, which are the above elements of leading 1 present in row number 3. So for this purpose we will apply the operation R1 minus 3R3 and R2 minus R3. So by applying these two operations, row number 1 and 2 will be modified and row number 3 will be as it is. So the resultant matrix is 1, 2, 0, 0 in the first row, 0, 1, 0, 0 in the second row, 0, 0, 1, 0 in the third row. Now we will make 2, 0, which is above the leading 1, which is present in row number 2. So for that purpose we will apply this operation, that is R1 minus 2R2. So by applying this operation, row number 1 will be modified and row number 2 and 3 will be as it is. So we have 1, 0, 0, 0 in the first row, 0, 1, 0, 0 in the second row, 0, 0, 1, 0 in the third row. So this is the required reduced row echelon form. Now the corresponding system of equation is given by 1x1 plus 0x2 plus 0x3 equals to 0. It means indirectly we have x1 equals to 0. So this is from row number 1. So from row number 2, 0x1 plus 1x2 plus 0x3 equals to 0. So indirectly we have x2 equals to 0. And from row number 3 we have 0x1 plus 0x2 plus 1x3 equals to 0. So that is x3 equals to 0. Therefore the system has trivial solution, as you can see that x1, x2, x3 all are 0. Now we will see example number 2 related to this topic. Solve the following homogeneous system of linear equations by Gauss-Jordan method. So these are the given system of equations and we will find out the solution of these system of equations using Gauss-Jordan method. So first of all, we will write down the matrix form of the system, and that is minus 1, 0, 1, 2 in the first row, minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1 in the second row, 0, minus 1, 1, 3 in the third row, 1, minus 2, 1, 4 in the fourth row. And along with this, we have a column matrix of variables. That is x1, x2, x3, x4, and in the right hand side we have a 0 vector. Now the augmented matrix of the system is writing matrix A along with 0 matrix. Now reducing the augmented matrix to row echelon form. So we require leading 1 at position 1, 1. So for that purpose we will interchange row number 1 and 4. So applying this operation R1 4. Now we will make minus 1, 0, minus 1 to 0, which are below leading 1 present at position 1, 1. So for that purpose we will apply the operation R2 plus R1 and R4 plus R1. So by applying these two operations, row number 1 and 3 will be as it is and row number 2 and 4 will be modified. So 1, minus 2, 1, 4, 0, these are the elements in row number 1. then after 0, minus 1, 1, 3, 0, this is row number 2, then after 0, minus 1, 1, 3, 0, this is row number 3, and then after 0, minus 2, 2, 6, 0, this is row number 4. Now to make minus 1, which is a first non-zero element in row number 2 from the left hand side to 1, for that purpose we will multiply row number 2 by minus 1. So row number 2 will be modified only and row number 1, 3 and 4 will be as it is. Now we have to make 0, minus 1 and minus 2, which are the elements below the leading one in row number 2. So for that purpose we will apply these operations, that is R3 plus R2 and R4 plus 2R2. So by applying these two operations, row number 3 and row number 4 will be modified and row number 1 and 2 will be as it is. So this is the resultant matrix, that is 1 minus 2, 1, 4, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 3, 0, and row number 3 and row number 4 are 0 rows. Now this is a row echelon form of the augmented matrix. Now we will reduce this matrix to reduce row echelon form. You can see that leading one is present in column number 1 and in column number 2. So we will make minus 2 to 0, which is the element above the leading one in row number 2. So for that purpose we will apply this operation, that is R1 plus 2R2. So row number 1 will be modified and row number 2, 3 and 4 will be as it is. And row number 1 is 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, 0. Now this matrix is in reduced row echelon form. Now you can see that the leading one is present in column number 1 and in column number 2. Whereas it is absent in column number 3 and in column number 4. So variable x3 and variable x4 are free variables, whereas variable x1 and variable x2 are called leading variables. Now the corresponding system of equations is given by x1 minus 1x3 minus 2x4 equals to 0. This is from row number 1. Now from row number 2 we have x2 minus x3 minus 3x4, that is equals to 0. Now making the subject of x1 from equation number 1. So we have x1 equals to x3 plus 2x4, and from equation number 2 making the subject of x2, and x2 equals to x3 plus 3x4. Now suppose x3 equals to k1 and x4 equals to k2, as x3 and x4 are free variables. So from equation of x1 we have x1 equals to k1 plus 2k2, replacing x3 by k1 and x4 by k2. Similarly, from the equation of x2, replacing x3 by k1 and x4 by k2, we have x2 equals to k1 plus 3k2. Here k1 and k2 may have any value. Therefore, the system has an infinite solution and the values of the variables are x1 equals to k1 plus 2k2, x2 equals to k1 plus 3k2, x3 equals to k1 and x4 equals to k2. So in today's lecture, we have discussed what is homogeneous system of linear equations, and we have seen the steps how to find out the solution of homogeneous system of linear equations using Gauss-Jordan method. We have seen two examples related to these topics. In example number 1, we have got a trivial solution, and in example number 2, we have got an infinite solution. Thank you for watching this video. I will see you in the next lecture.